Hello, welcome to this channel, Gain Java Knowledge. Hello everyone, welcome to this channel, Gain Java Knowledge. And today in this video, we are going to understand what are microservices and the architecture of microservices and the advantage and disadvantage of microservices. Because in this day, everyone wants to create application using microservices architecture. And we will also compare it with the monolithic architecture that we used before the microservice architecture. Okay, let's start with monolithic architecture. What is the monolithic architecture? Before I tell you about microservices, let's see the architecture that prevailed before microservices. And that is the monolithic architecture. In layman term, you can say that it's similar to a big container, wherein all the software components of an application are assembled together and tightly packaged with each other. These are the challenge for the microservices that we faced during monolithic architecture. And these are the challenges like inflexible. Monolithic applications cannot be built using different technologies. We must use the same programming language. So we can use different language for different all services. For all services, we need to use same language. If we are working on Java, we must need to use Java with all the services. In catalog service, order service, payment service, in all service, we need to use the same language. And the second challenge we faced during monolithic architecture, that is unreliable. Even if one feature of the system does not work, then the entire system does not work. For example, in our application that is e-store, if our order service is not working during monolithic architecture, then our all server will go down and nothing will work. And this is the big disadvantage. And the next one is unscalable. And applications cannot be scaled easily since each time the application needs to be updated and the complete system has to be rebuilt. If we're doing changes in any service, then we must need to deploy all the services together, and this is also the big disadvantage. And the next challenge that we face during monolithic architecture is blocks continuous development, and many features of the application cannot be built and deployed at the same time, so it slows that development. And development in the monolithic application during monolithic application takes a lot of time to be built, because we need to deploy all these services, so it takes lots of time since each and every feature has to be built one after each other, and so it is not fit for complex applications. Features of the complex application have tightly coupled together with each other. So this was the challenge that we faced during the monolithic architecture, and to overcome this disadvantage we need to use microservices. Next thing is that why we need to use microservices. And first we will see why we need to use microservices, because of its continuous delivery. And second feature is maximize deployment velocity. And third is faster innovation to adapt to changing market conditions. And fourth is enable developers. And fifth is reduce the costs. So we will discuss one by one. First is the continuous delivery. And the microservices provide the ideal architecture for continuous delivery. With microservice, each application resides in a separate container, and along with the environment it needs to run. Because of this, each application can be edited in its container without the risk of interfering with other application. For example, if we have one application and that contains multiple microservices, like we have multiple microservices, catalog microservice, order microservice, and payment service. If our one service is going down, then our other services will work fine, and we will fix the bug in the same service and redeploy only the one service if we are working with microservice architecture. So it will reduce the cost. And the second one is maximize the deployment velocity. It means microservice architecture allows you to maximize the deployment velocity and application reliability by helping you move at the speed of the market. Since applications run in their own containerized environment, application can be moved anywhere without altering the environment. And if any application works in development, it will work for the customer, and the speed up time to market and increase the product reliability if you are working with microservice architecture. And the next most important feature that provided microservices, faster innovation to adapt to changing market condition, because in this time the language are growing very fastly, and microservices can also help you to adapt more quickly to the changing market condition, because microservices allows application to be updated and tested quickly, because we can test only single microservices, no need to test all microservices together. So you can allow market trends and adapt your product transfer and make the product faster. And microservices also gives you an edge when it comes to innovation, since the developer can experiment on application without fear of causing problem elsewhere. Because if we have 5 microservices in one application and we want to perform any operation or any experiment on any single microservices, then it will not affect the other microservices. It will affect only single microservices, and we can do perform any experiment without causing problem elsewhere. And the next one is, it will enable developers. If we are going with microservice architecture, then each component of an application can exist in its own container. So independently we can manage and update the each microservice. And this means that developer can build application from multiple components and program each component in the language best suited to its functions. For example, in our application, if we have 5 microservices, and in 2 microservices if we want to use Python, and in other microservices we want to use Java, then we can use, but it was not possible in monolithic architecture. So rather than having to choose a single less than ideal language to use for everything, and it will also reduce the costs. In a monolithic architecture can be expensive, because every part of the monolithic interacts with each other parts, so a change in one place affect other parts also. So this means a lot more work for developers and operations to perform the developers. And what are the microservices and the advantages of microservices? Now we will discuss. Microservices is a service oriented architecture pattern, that we can say SOA, service oriented architecture pattern, wherein applications are built as a collection of various smallest independent service unit, here multiple microservices in a single application. So microservices are an architectural style that develops a single application as a set of small services. It is a set of application that contains multiple microservices, and each service runs its own process. The service communicate with clients and often each other using lightweight protocols, often our messaging or HTTP. Here our microservices will interact with other microservices also by using lightweight protocols. Now let's start and discuss the advantages of the microservices. And the first main advantage of microservices, it is small in size. So microservices is an implementation of a SOA design pattern. It is recommended to keep your service as much as you can. Basically, a service should not perform more than one business. Hence, it will be abusively small in size and easy to maintain. And one microservices will handle order service, other microservices will use for payment service, and next microservices will use for buy order. So each microservices will handle only single service, so it will be lightweight and small in size. It will be easy to maintain if one microservice is focusing on one service. And the second main feature or advantage of microservices is focused. As we know, each microservices is designed to deliver only one business task, While designing a microservice, the architecture should be concerned about the focal point of the service, which it is deliverable. By definition, one microservice should be full stack. It will contain its UI part, its backend code, and it will be full stack in nature and should be committed to deliver only one business property. And the next advantage of microservices is autonomous. Each microservice should be an autonomous business unit of the entire application. Hence, the application becomes more loosely coupled, which helps to reduce the maintenance cost. And the next advantage of this, technology heterogeneity. Microservices support different technologies to communicate with each other in one business unit, and which helps the developer to use the correct technology at the correct place. And by implementing a heterogeneous system, one can obtain maximum security, speed, and the scalability of the application. So it is a big advantage. And the resilience is the next advantage. Resilience is a property of isolating a software unit, and the microservices follow highest level of resilience in building methodology. Hence, whenever the one unit fails, it does not impact the entire business resilience. It's another property which implements highly scalable and less coupled system, because each microservices is loosely coupled with other microservices. If our one service will be failed, our other service will work fine, and we will fix the bug in the single microservices and redeploy again only single microservice. So it will be deployment will be faster and not affecting to the other microservices. So it is a faster and scalable. And the next advantage is ease of deployment. As the entire application is subdivided into small pieces of units, every component should be full stack in nature, and all of them can be deployed in any environment very easily with less time complexity, unlike other monolithic applications of the same kind. Now let's discuss the disadvantage of the microservices have also. So we will discuss this. In disadvantage, due to the technical, and the first disadvantage is distributed system, and due to the technical heterogeneity, different technology will be used to develop different parts of a microservices. In each microservices, we can use different technology. For example, here we can use Python, here we can use Java, and here we can also use .NET. We can use different technology for different microservices. A huge set of skilled professionals are required to support this big heterogeneous distributed software. Hence, the distributed and heterogeneity stands as a number one disadvantage using the microservices, because the developer must be highly skilled. The next disadvantage is cost. Microservices is costly, as you have to maintain different server space for different business tasks. And the third is enterprise readiness. Microservices architecture can be considered as a conglomerate of different technologies, as technology evolving day by day. Hence, it is quite difficult to make a microservice application enterprise ready to compare to conventional software development model. And this was the disadvantage of microservices. Okay, now let's compare the monolithic architecture with microservices architecture. In the microservices, every unit of the entire application should be the smallest, and it should be able to deliver one specific business goal. We can deliver only single microservice at a time if we are working with microservice architecture. But in the monolithic architecture, a single code base for all business goals, we need to deploy all code together. So it is a large process. And if we are working with microservices, service startup is relatively quickly, because we can deploy only single microservices and other microservices already deployed, then it will work fine and quick. But here, if we have did any changes in our application, then service startup takes more time. And with microservice architecture, fault isolation is easy. Even if one service goes down, for example, or one microservice goes down, other than continue to function, this will not affect to the other microservices. But if you are working with monolithic architecture, and fault isolation is difficult here, because if any specific feature is not working, then complete system goes down. In order to handle this issue, the application needs to rebuild and retested and also redeployed. And if you are working with microservice architecture, all microservices should be loosely coupled so that changes made in one does not affect the other. If you are working in one microservice, it will not affect the other microservices. But if you are working with monolithic architecture, then monolithic architecture is tightly coupled. Changes in one module of code affect to the other modules also. So it is a single instance, we can say it is a single instance. And but in microservice architecture, data is federated. This allow individual microservices to adopt a data model best suited for its need. But in monolithic, data is centralized in a single DB. Here we can use multiple instance. And small focus teams parallelly work in and faster the deployment. If you are working with microservice, here we can use one team, here we can use separate team, and in the same different microservices we can use different team, and it will increase the speed of deployment and development. But if you are working with monolithic architecture, large team and considerable team management effort is required. Okay, thanks and watching for this video.